She said the same thing next day to Mrs. Tom Sentner, who had come down to help her pick her geese. They were at work in the kitchen with a big tubful of feathers between them, and on the table a row of dead birds, which Leon had killed and brought in. Josephine was enveloped in a shapeless print wrapper and had an apron tied tightly around her head to keep the down out of her beautiful hair, of which she was rather proud. "What do you think, Ida?" she said with a hearty laugh at the recollection. "David Hartley was here to tea last night and asked me to marry him again. There's a persistent man for you. I can't brag of ever having had many beaux, but I've certainly had my fair share of proposals." Mrs. Tom did not laugh. Her thin little face, with its faded prettiness, looked as if she never laughed. "Why won't you marry him?" she said fretfully. "Why should I?" retorted Josephine. "Tell me that, Ida Sentner." "Because it's high time you were married," said Mrs. Tom decisively. "I don't believe in women living single, and I don't see what better you can do than take Tom Hartley." Josephine looked at her sister with the interested expression of a person who is trying to understand some mental attitude in another, which is a standing puzzle to her. Ida's evident wish to see her married always amused Josephine. Ida had married very young, and for 15 years her life had been one of drudgery and ill health. Tom Sentner was a lazy, shiftless fellow. He neglected his family and was drunk half his time. Meadowby people said that he beat his wife when on the spree, but Josephine did not believe that, because she did not think that Ida would keep from telling her if it were so. Ida Sentner was not given to bearing her trials in silence. Had it not been for Josephine's assistance, Tom Sentner's family would have stood on excellent chance of starvation. Josephine practically kept them, and her generosity never failed or stinted. She fed and clothed her nephews and nieces, and all the gray socks, whose destination puzzled David so much, went to the Sentners. As for Josephine herself, she had a good farm, a comfortable house, a plump bank account, and was an independent, unworried woman. And yet, in the face of all this, Mrs. Tom Sentner could bewail the fact that Josephine had no husband to look out for her. Josephine shrugged her shoulders and gave up the conundrum, merely saying ironically, in reply to her sister's remark, "And go to live with Zillah Hartley? You know very well you wouldn't have to do that. Ever since John Hartley's wife at the creek died, he's been wanting Zillah to go and keep house for him, and if David got married, Zillah'd go quick. Catch her staying there if you were mistress. And David has such a beautiful house. It's 10 times finer than yours, though I don't deny yours is comfortable.